Of you. Today we'll discuss about the emulsions or pharmaceutical emulsion and its types. What are the pharmaceutical emulsions? Emulsion are the liquid type of dosage form in which one liquid is immersed into the another liquid, that is called as the emulsion. Now under this lecture we'll cover the five types of your emulsion. Under this emulsions basic information, then what are the stability problems of emulsion, what are the manufacturing process of emulsion or the methods, then what are the different tests used for the preparation of detection of the emulsion, and then what are the various types of application of the our emulsion. Next. Now under this the emulsions are having the, we can say, different types. We'll see under this section then what are the different classification methods of emulsion, what are the theories involved inside the stabilization of emulsion, and what are the different types of ingredients or the additives used for the preparation of the emulsion. Next. Now dispersed system. Actually this is one different type of concept which is existed in our pharmaceutical era. That is, the dispersed means dispersed material in another one type of phase. That is called as the dispersed system. Emulsion are the one type of system which belongs to the dispersed system, as well as suspension also is the dispersed type of preparation. Here emulsion is nothing but the dispersion in which the liquid is dispersed into the another liquid, that is called as the emulsion. And the suspension means the solid material dispersed into the another liquid material, that is called as the suspension. Now emulsion can be defined into the different way. First one is the thermodynamically stable emulsion. Means what? Those emulsion which are thermodynamically unstable, or they can be unstable because of the changes in the preparation, they are called as the thermodynamically unstable emulsions. Another definition of emulsion is that the emulsion in which we are dispersing the liquid or the oil into the another liquid phase, that is called as the another type of emulsion. Next one is the regarding the internal phase as well as external phase of the emulsion. In the emulsion we are dispersing one phase into the another phase. The dispersed phase is called as the internal phase, as well as it is also called as discontinuous phase. In another way we can say that in which we are dispersing that phase, the dispersed phase disperses into the continuous phase or the dispersion medium. So that is called as the external phase or the continuous phase. Next. Another thing is the regarding the classification of emulsion. Emulsions are classified into the two types. First one is the OWO type as well as WO type, that is called as the simple emulsions. And then another different type of our emulsion is that depending on the size of globules we are categorizing the emulsions. That is the two types, macro emulsion and micro emulsion. Macro emulsion when we are calling as when the globule size is ranges from 0.2 to 50 millimeter, and the micro emulsion means the globule size is ranges from 0.01 to 0.21 mm. Then another thing is the another classification of emulsion is that simple emulsion, multiple emulsion as well as micro emulsion. Simple emulsion means they are also called as the macro emulsion, where the globule size is large and they are generally the diameter of globule is 0.1 micrometer, and they are simply called as WO type or OW type. Then multiple emulsion means when the another one phase is existed into the internal phase, that is inside the globule, then there three phase will be existed. That's why they are called as the multiple type of emulsion. So here OWOW as well as WOW, these are the two type of we can say name is given to the multiple emulsion. Another one is the micro emulsion. Micro emulsion means the globule size is very small, that is nothing but the nano size. Okay, so they are thermodynamically stable type of preparation, they are optically stable one, and they are called as the micro emulsion. So now the next part we will cover into the next lecture. Thank you very much.